Now let us begin with chapter 14 of your grammar, kinds of sentences. This is the topic which you must have read in your previous class also. So now we'll read in a little depth. So look at the picture given over here. Which group of words describe the picture completely? Over here you can see a picture on the right hand side. Okay, so to the beach, in the evening, the family had gone to the beach in the evening. So among these four sentences, which sentence describes this picture perfectly and correctly? Yes, the sentence which is in the fourth one, that means the last group of words, make complete sense. So what is the sentence? With this we can understand the group of words which makes complete sense. Okay, so in order to make complete sense, a sentence begins with a capital letter. This is known to you that whenever we start writing a sentence, koi naya sentence jab hum start karte hain, the first letter of the first word always is in capital. Second, has words placed in a proper order? We have to check whether the arrangement of words are in proper order. Okay, see, for example, meant to work went the on to Sunday. So is this sentence making any sense? No. Why? Because they are not arranged in proper sequence. So what would be the correct arrangement of the words? Correct arrangement would be the men went to work on Sunday too. So this sentence is making sense. This sentence is meaningful. Okay, and remember that the sentence always ends with the punctuation of full stop, a question mark or an exclamation mark. Sentence kaun se punctuation se end hota hai? Full stop se, question mark se ya exclamation mark se. Now in the first exercise, what you have to do is you have to rearrange the words. Sab jumbled hai, sab shuffled hai, all the words are shuffled. So you have to arrange them in the proper sequence so as to make the sentence meaningful. So see the first one. One saw a piece of cheese, a crow, a fox in its beak fly off with. So these are all jumbled and they have been arranged in this correct sequence. So a fox once saw a crow fly off with a piece of cheese in its beak. Let us take the next sentence. Settled off a tree, the crow on the branch. Not making sense? Let us make the sense of this sentence. So the sentence would be like, the crow settled on the branch of a tree. The sentence would be, I repeat, this crow settled on the branch of a tree. Now let us take this next sentence. But he knew the fox with him wanted the cheese, would not the crow share it? So the answer would be, the fox wanted the cheese, but he knew the crow would not share it with him. We have covered all the words? Yes. So the sentence would be, the fox wanted the cheese, but he knew the crow would not share it with him. So this is how you have to solve this exercise. Now rest sentences to be done by you. Try to solve them by your own. Now let us now take a look at this conversation. Mohan, what a beautiful painting. Who is the painter? Rohan said, I am the painter. Please do not touch it. The paint is still wet. So now you will notice that each sentence is of a different kind. The first one is an exclamation. Okay, how you can understand? What a beautiful painting. This is the expression. Isme hamare paas exclamation mark laga hua hai. So this is For the first sentence is an exclamation. The second is the question. The third is the statement, a simple statement. And the fourth sentence is the request. So you can see there are four kinds of sentences, four types of sentences you can see over here. So with this you can come to the conclusion that there are four kinds of sentences: exclamatory sentence, interrogative sentence, assertive and imperative sentence. Now let us define them. Assertive sentence. Assertive को हम declarative भी बोलते हैं. Okay? The sentence which are in a statement form, जो simple statement form में रहता है, that gives you an information about something. So, कुछ declare करना है, कुछ statement देना, कुछ information देना is a simple assertive or declarative kind of sentence. See, for example, the day is very hot. A simple statement. Mimi lives in a big cottage. A simple information. Jayant is a painter. He paints really well. So this is the declaration. Kuch bhi sentences simple form of statements mein rehta hai ya declaration mein rehta hai is known as assertive or declarative sentence. Now come to imperative. Imperative sentences are the sentences which gives commands or request, make a wish. Okay, see for example, shut the door. Ye ek order hai. When we give the order, that statement would be known as imperative sentence. Ye yaad rakhna, imperative sentence stands for an order, a request and a wish. Okay. See the second sentence, please give me a glass of water. This is the request. And have a safe journey. This is a wish. Okay. So, the sentences which gives order, which are in the form of order, a request or a wish, are imperative sentences. Now come to the third kind, that is interrogative. What happens in interrogative? With the word itself you can understand, interrogative means to question. Interrogate, to interrogate. किसी को interrogate करना मतलब क्या होता है? To ask the questions. So, whichever sentence is in the question form would be known as interrogative sentences. So, a sentence that asks a question is called interrogative sentence. See, for example, what are you doing? This is the question ending with question mark. Where do you study? Again, the question ending with question mark. So these are known as interrogative sentence. Now come to the fourth one, exclamatory sentence and exclamation. So a sentence that expresses sudden and strong feelings. Sudden and strong feelings such as surprise. Surprise wala jo statement hota hai, wonder wala jo statement rehta hai, pity, sympathy, happiness or gratitude. You can say sorry. You can say that the sentences showing some expressions of feelings, in that case, they would be known as exclamatory sentence. So say, hooray, we have won the match. Oh no, I lost my post. Okay, so you can see whenever there is an exclamation mark in a sentence, they would be known as exclamatory sentences. Now, read this passage from the famous novel by Charles Dickens, A Christmas Carol. Scrooge nephews was all in a glow. His face was ruddy and handsome, his eyes sparkled and his breath smoked again. Christmas, Sir Humbug Uncle, said Scrooge nephew. You don't mean that I am sure. I do, said Scrooge. Merry Christmas. What right have you to be merry? What reason have you to be merry? You are poor enough. Come then, returned the nephew gaily. What right have you to be dismal? What reason have you to be morose? You are rich enough. Get out of here, said Scrooge. So over here you can understand that with these sentences you have to take out the sentences which are in at assertive, interrogative sentence, exclamatory sentence and imperative sentence. So there are few sentences in this paragraph which are assertive, which are exclamatory, which are interrogative and which are imperative. So you have to sort them out. This stands as for your homework. This is to be done by you. Assertive sentence can be further divided into two parts, affirmative and negative sentence. See, for example, it is raining today. My name is Kashmira and this is a table. These are all affirmative sentences. Affirmative sentences means positive sentence, positive form of sentence. Then what are negative sentences? The sentences having no, not and never word kind of words. Okay, this sentence mein no, not or never aa jata hai. Those sentences are known as negative sentences. See, for example, it is not sunny today. That is not the dress I wanted. And you have not done your work today. So yahan pe what are the words? Not, not and not. These are all negative sentences. Why? Kyunki isme not hai hamare paas. Okay. So look at these two set of sentences. I am happy today. I am not unhappy today. दोनों का मीनिंग सेम है बट डिफरेंस कहाँ है? ये जो सेंटेंस है ये अफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस है, दैट मीन्स पॉजिटिव, और ये जो सेंटेंस है ये नेगेटिव सेंटेंस है. ठीक है, यहाँ पे नॉट लगाया और हमने हैप्पी को कन्वर्ट किया अनहैप्पी में जस्ट टू शो कि वो हैप्पी है. ओके, सी द नेक्स्ट वन. शीला इज क्वाइट शॉर्ट, शीला इज नॉट टॉल. अगेन दिस इज अफर्मेटिव एंड दिस इज negative. Why? We have added not, or is sentence ka meaning isse match ho positive wale sentence se. So short ka opposite humne tall laga diya. Okay, so this is how it works when we have to convert a positive sentence into negative. So both these sets of sentences mean the same. The first sentence is an affirmative sentence, the second sentence is a negative sentence. Okay, so we can change an affirmative sentence into the negative by putting a negative and adding a negative prefix to the word or using the opposite of the word given in the affirmative sentence. Okay, so let us take the third exercise now where we have to convert the affirmative into negative sentence. He is quite old now. So what we have done, we have इतना याद रखना है हमको, अगर जब भी हम कन्वर्जन करते हैं affirmative sentence का negative में, negative का जो meaning निकलना चाहिए, meaning should be the same of affirmative and negative. भले से आप उसमें not use कर रहे हो, भले से आप उसमें opposite words use कर रहे हो, meaning तो same ही होगा उसका. Okay, so he is quite old now. Okay, now we have to use not in this sentence. Negative form of word use करना है इसमें हमें. ठीक है, so he is not very young now. Quite का very कर दिया, old का young कर दिया, opposite use हो गए. Okay, so this is the conversion is going to take place. So over here you can see the meanings are same. He is quite old now, मतलब ये काफी बूढ़े हो चुके हैं. ही इज नॉट वेरी यंग नाउ, मतलब अब ये ज्यादा जवान नहीं रहे. इसका मतलब क्या? अब वो थोड़े बूढ़े हो गए हैं. ही हैज बिकम अ लिटिल ओल्ड. मीनिंग इज द सेम. व्हाट वी हैव टू जस्ट डू इज टू प्लेस नो, नॉट और नेवर इन द सेंटेंस टू चेंज द सेंटेंस इनटू नेगेटिव सेंटेंस. सी द नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस. मीरा इज यंगर देन गणेश. सो यू कैन हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ सेंटेंसेस ओवर हियर. You can write it as Meera is not, not लगा देंगे यहाँ पे. Younger का opposite क्या हो जाएगा? Older. Not older than Ganesh. So the sentence would be Meera is not older than Ganesh. Okay? Next, see, I know nobody in this office. I know nobody in the office. Nobody ka opposite ho jayega anybody. Remember. So the sentence should be I don't know anybody in this office. Okay. So this is how you have to convert these sentences. Try to do it by your own, as in practice. And if you face any problem, ask me. Let us take the fourth exercise, wherein you have to convert the negative sentence into affirmative. See the first one. There is no rose without a thorn. Okay. So no itself showing ki this sentence hamara negative mein. What we have to do? We have to remove no. Okay. And we have to use like every rose has a thorn. So without ka opposite hamara ho jayega has. So every rose has a thorn. Now let us take the next sentence. This is not an impossible task. So not or impossible, inke opposite words use karenge. So kya sentence banega? This is possible. That's it. Yeah, this task is possible. This task is possible. Okay. Let's take the next. See, the principal did not disagree with the plan. Did not and disagree. Did not hatana hai aur disagree ko form change karna hai, opposite use karenge. The sentence would be like the principal agreed with the plan. That's it. Okay, so this is how you have to now change the sentences from negative to affirmative and affirmative to negative. But always keep that one thing in mind, that whenever you are changing a negative sentence into affirmative or affirmative sentence into negative, in that case the meaning should be the same. ठीक है, भले से आप नेगेटिव में आके वर्ड्स पूरे चेंज कर देते हो, नो लगा देते हो, नॉट लगा देते हो, नेवर लगा देते हो, यू राइट द हैप्पी वर्ड एज अनहैप्पी, बट अगर उसका मीनिंग डिराइव करोगे तो मीनिंग वही निकलेगा. ओके, सो ट्राई टू सॉल्व द रिमेनिंग सेंटेंसेस बाय योर ओन, एंड इफ यू फेस एनी प्रॉब्लम यू कैन आस्क मी इन डाउट क्लियरिंग सेशन. थैंक यू.